Why should someone dose twice a day rather than once a day? What is the advantage, and how would I know if I should try twice a day dosing? Would the doses be equal in milligrams? Some people have very complex issues. So let's go back to fibromyalgia. So fibromyalgia isn't necessarily always a single entity. It's a general description of a variety of symptoms, usually centered around inflammation, that they don't necessarily have a direct correlation as to the causative or the root cause of what's going on. In situations like that, we might use low dose naltrexone twice a day because of more pain control versus taking care of the autoimmune issues. Usually, when we're dealing with autoimmune, we're only dosing it once a day, but we have found some individuals do better than on twice a day. Those doses are not necessarily equal. Sometimes they're very small at one end of the day and a little bit bigger at the other end of the day. How do you know when you can try that? Well, for some people, especially with fibromyalgia, they're on once a day dosing and it's just not cutting it. It's just not enough. So what we might do is, let's say they were on 4.5 milligrams at bedtime. Then what we might do is actually cut that down and give them half milligram in the morning that they could take a little bit in the morning and then reduce their bedtime dose. So we're still not going above 4.5, 5, 6 milligrams, but we're splitting that up. Dr. Norman Marcus uses for chronic pain 0.1 milligram up to 4 times a day. But again, this is specific to his patients under his protocol. And again, because low dose naltrexone doesn't have this disease state equals this dosing routine, it literally is all about the individual. And we try something for a period of time, and if it's working great, fabulous. Do we adjust doses? Usually, before someone finds their happy dose, we have adjusted that dose maybe 9 to 12 times.